If you were to sit me down and force me to identify the one specific area where most beginner guitar players and intermediate guitar players, and even some advanced players, believe it or not, have trouble, it would be rhythm. Hands down, rhythm. Rhythm is the one major cause for frustration for most beginner and intermediate players, up to the point where people actually believe that they lack a sense of rhythm, and that's just not true. Rhythm is a difficult thing to master for one very obvious reason. It's unnatural. Keeping quantized time, metronomic time, you know, perfect time, is unnatural. Nothing in nature keeps perfect time. Okay, that's why drummers have to work very, very hard on their rudiments, okay, with their sticks and their pads. They work on their paradiddles, they work on their rudiments, they work on breaking down the components of rhythm. And this is something that guitar players rarely do, because it's really easy to jump right into the playing and read tabs and read chords and read notation and just, you know, play. But we forget to work on the sense of rhythm, the inner sense of rhythm. Now, there are a lot of times where people tell me, you always tell us to create our own variations on your arrangements, and we just don't know how to do that. And the secret is rhythm. Just play around with the rhythm. That's what I mean. Add arpeggios, add strumming, add slaps, add chords. Just, you know, enjoy the music. But enjoying the music is easier said than done if you don't have a very concrete and deep sense of rhythm. And that's why I created the Rhythm Mastery course, okay, to help you develop an inner sense of rhythm and be in full control of your rhythmic sense. And that means being aware of where you are in the music, being aware of the bars, being aware of where you are in the bar, being aware of where the one is, where the first beat is, and when it's about to come again. So you can create syncopations. Syncopation is N1, okay? And you can create offbeat. Offbeat is playing on the eighth notes that aren't the 1, 2, 3, 4 beats. And creating grooves by adding silence. Silence is the secret sauce, the secret ingredient of rhythm, because silence creates groove. Okay, even if you just take quarter notes and eighth notes, okay, 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, and you just add a little bit of silence in there, but by taking some of those notes out, you get immediate groove. 1 and 4. 1 and 3 and 4. 1, 2, and 4. Okay? So add silence. And we go over all that in the Rhythm Mastery course. Now you can practice this by yourself, but I'd appreciate it if you want my help. So I'm here to help. That's why I'm here. So the next step would be to break the music down into more notes, into 16th notes, okay, and then doing the same exercises by playing different 16th notes inside the bar, okay, and that gives you literally tons of options. It's nearly endless, the amount of variations you can have when you have 16th notes. And then we add triplets, and then we add the shuffle beat, and in all that, We do enough exercises in the course to help you understand, really, really understand the rhythm. Not just read it off of a page, not just copy someone else's rhythm. Okay, you'll know why each note is there, because you'll be able to feel it. If you look at guitar players, you know, all across the board, who radiate energy while they play, whose music really shines, it's not always about the technique. Sometimes it's the groove, and sometimes it's a simple groove, but you'll see them dancing along to the music. You'll see them bobbing their heads, or, you know, just moving their whole body while they play. Even their hands, their hand movement would be very expressive. Their legs would be tapping, they would move their whole leg up and down. That's because they feel the rhythm internally, okay? They've developed it. Nobody's born with a rhythm sense, okay, with a musical rhythm sense. And unfortunately, most guitar players stay at a very basic level rhythmically. That's why you keep hearing the same rhythm patterns when people strum chords. Okay, there are tons, really, literally, truckfuls of, you know, figurative trucks, of rhythm patterns that you can strum. Even if you take the basic strumming patterns, you can manipulate them and mutate them into really interesting music. But most people just don't do that because they're not in full control of their rhythm. Okay, so again, you can do it on your own. You can just practice the rudiments. But if you want my help, go to LickNRiff.com/courses and you'll see the Rhythm Mastery course alongside the ear training and arrangement courses. And I'd be more than happy. It would be my pleasure to teach you and help you on your journey to become a better musician. So thank you very much for your time, and I'll see you the next lesson. Bye for now. Enjoy.